One of the greatest challenges a newly married couple faces today is how to blend a family. But have hope. It can be done. Stay tuned and find out. Hello, and welcome to Living a Godly Marriage. My name is Melvin Green, and I'm co-hosting with my dear, lovely wife, Von Seal Green. Blending a family can be complex, and it can be difficult with many challenges. We know because we've been through it. But we have learned that there are tips you can follow and resources you can use to make blending the family successful. And that's the focus of our show tonight. But Von Seal, let's start with you and tell us, what is a blended family?
Well, a blended family is one with two parents where one or both have children from a previous marriage or relationship.
Mm-hmm.
Also, there are many types of blended families. Both parents are divorced or have children from a previous relationship, or one parent is divorced with the child and the other adult has never married. One or both parents is a widow or widower. It is the most common family in the U.S. today.
It certainly is, and probably the next wedding that someone goes to, it's probably going to be a blended family, where either one or both parties have kids and they're coming together. What we're going to do tonight is cover tips for blending a family. So we're going to be alternating slides. We're going to be sharing tips and information with you. And so we encourage you to follow along with us.
And lessons learned.
Yes, and lessons learned. Number one, start referring to each child as your child. They are indeed your son or your daughter, especially when you introduce them to others. Ask the children what they want to call the new parents. Now, this is really important if they are teenagers, because, again, they have their ideas on how they want parents to be called. Don't force the kids to use mom or dad, except if they want to use the term stepmom or stepdad. Now, I'll leave it up to you. Some families decide to use first name for the parents, but I think we prefer the, you know, stepmom or stepdad. Another tip is ask the children how they want the new parent to be introduced to their friends. It might be awkward, for example, if you introduce yourself as their dad, where their friends know that you're not their biological dad. So ask the children how they want the new parent to be introduced.
We're going to share some tips for blending a family. And this is what pretty much works for us. It may be different for other families. But seek to get to know and build a relationship with each child, because they are different. We have three daughters. So they're all very different. I refer to them as my daughters because that's how I feel about them. And spend time. It's important to spend time with each one separately.
Yes.
Learn their likes, dislikes, and preferences.
Mm-hmm. They don't all think alike. They don't all like the same things. Remember when we had an early family discussion about dinner and when we should have dinner. They wanted different menus. So again, we had to work through that.
And that's okay. So lower your expectations and expect time to blend. It takes time, and be patient and expect challenges. There are going to be challenges, and that's okay.
Mm-hmm.
Blending a family can be complex and stressful at times.
That's right.
Especially if a biological parent is deceased, that adds another element to the situation. What you might want to do to include or to recognize that parent that has passed on is at the wedding, light a candle to recognize the deceased parents. And this shows the children love and respect.
Yes, yes, that's a nice gesture.
It's a nice gesture. And it's especially important if a parent has deceased, because you don't want the children to think that you're trying to replace that parent.
That's right.
So you have to respect that relationship.
Yes, these tips are really interesting, aren't they?
They are very helpful.
Yeah, and if families can follow them, it'll really help to blend the family. So let's continue with our next slide. Expect natural resistance and learn how to deal with disharmony. Be patient, thick-skinned, understanding, and forgiving. It's easy for a child to say something like, but you're not my dad. Yeah, you're not their biological dad. And that could be very disturbing. But remember, the inclination you may have is to correct the child, but connecting with the child is probably better at that time. Also, a child may want to display pictures of a deceased or divorced parent. That should be expected. And so where's the place they can do that, Vonsil?
Well, they can put them in the bedroom or a place that's sort of neutral. If you don't want them in the dining room while you're eating.
That's right. That's right.
The dining room table.
But their room, they can certainly move the pictures there and put them up on the walls. So it's maintaining that spirit of cooperating with the child. If you be dogmatic, don't be surprised if they'll react like a dog and might bite you, so to speak.
You want to be very careful about that, especially if a parent is deceased.
Yes.
So that adds a whole nother sensitive element to the situation. So you want to be very careful.
And don't force children to take pictures with the new family. Give it time. They'll need time to adjust, and they may not be ready to take the new family picture. Vonsil?
So if a parent has died or divorced, expect expressions of grief or sadness on birthdays, holidays, or the anniversary of the death.
Yes.
So you want to be especially sensitive around those times. So the success of the blended family will depend on your relationship as a couple. A healthy marriage is the best gift and model you can give to your children.
And considering that you're blending, that's really important to have. You're setting the tone as the parents that you're working together. And so one way of really showing that is to do that. Really model the behavior that you want from them. Continuing.
Compliment your spouse's parenting skills and efforts in front of the kids. That is so important that you say positive things about the children's father or mother in front of the children.
And it's good to acknowledge that, especially if you've discussed it, that mom and dad are trying to do better and, you know, are adjusting just like you want them to adjust. It's good to acknowledge that you're adjusting as well. Never argue in front of the children and instead discuss issues in private.
This is very important not to argue in front of the children, especially if a parent has passed on, is deceased. You don't want to bring that tension into the household.
That's right.
So be very careful about that.
Right. Encourage members of the new family to focus on the future instead of the past and make new memories. I know as we were blending, that's something that you were encouraging me and the girls to do, was looking ahead, not neglecting or forgetting their past, but as a new family, we're making new memories.
And that's something I have to compliment you on, because you were very good about that. Making new memories.
Yes, thank you. Another tip is to encourage family members to get to know each other, to support and help each other. We are family, so we got to get to know each other. We have to support each other. Right. We're not rivals, we're family. We're on the same team and we need to help each other.
Yeah. And I think it's important too that you help the children understand that you're not trying to replace the mm-hmm. biological parent. So mm-hmm. be very careful about that.
Yes.
Just let them know you love them very much, but you're not trying to take mm-hmm. the place of their biological
right. parent. And discuss and set rules for posting on social media about the family. Oh, this can be critical. You need to have some rules there. If we have disagreements or things are not working out, it doesn't mean you go and vent on social media or put our business out in the streets, so to speak. That's not appropriate.
It's always a good idea to let the biological parent discipline their own child. Those children, I call them his children. Mm-hmm. I feel like they're my children as well. And I've said many times, I can't imagine loving them anymore if I had birthed them myself. Mm-hmm. When I think about them, I don't think about them as being my stepchildren. I think about them as being my children.
Right. As we talked about earlier, you right. know, in this case, your daughters. Mm-hmm. But I think it's one thing if I'm disciplining them when I'm home, but it's also important to realize and discuss what happens if I'm not there.
Right.
Okay. Mm-hmm. You know, it shouldn't be wait till your dad gets home. No, I've given you that authority and they understand that,
yes.
then things will go more smoothly. Continuing with the tips, watch how each child is adjusting. If anyone is struggling or seems too stressed, consider going to counseling. Children will adjust at different speeds, at different pace, depending upon their ages or depending upon their situation, their emotional makeup, et cetera. But keep an eye on how each child is adjusting and don't group them together. And have regular family meetings to see how everyone is doing. Discuss what's going well and what isn't going well. Be open and transparent about that. And identify what specific changes should be made by each parent or child. Notice I have changes made by the parent and not just the child.
Right. And if I may just mm-hmm. jump in here, that was something I had to work on with myself.
Mm-hmm.
Because I wanted everything to work perfectly and right away. And it wasn't going to happen because I had a certain expectation
mm-hmm.
based on my previous marriage.
Mm-hmm.
I had a really great relationship mm-hmm. with my former husband's children. And I still do, as a matter mm-hmm. of fact. And so I just had this expectation that things are going to work really well.
Right.
In this situation also. But everyone's a little different and you have to make allowances for that.
That's right.
So let the biological parent living elsewhere know you're not trying to replace them and will not badmouth them to the child, their children. Instead, you're just another adult caregiver and will support the parent's relationship with the child or children.
Mm-hmm. In other words, don't put the children in the middle there. Right. And, you know, that's not a good thing.
And believe the biological parent has good motives and intentions. If not, forgive and pray for them. So it's just as important to have a good relationship with the biological parent as it is with the children.
Mm-hmm.
Because you're on the same team, basically, mm-hmm. correct?
And hopefully they'll view that right. the same right. way. And you can appeal to them.
Yes.
You know, we're jointly raising this right. child
we're
now.
We're not adversaries.
Yeah, we're yeah. not adversaries. We're on the same team, just not living in the right. same home.
Yeah, and I'm and not appeal trying to take your right. place, or he's not trying to take the father's place. So that's very important to have those conversations.
That's right.
So everybody understands where mm-hmm. everybody is coming from.
That's so good. That's mm-hmm. so good.
So appeal to the parent to help raise the child. Discuss and reach agreement on the rules. And mm-hmm. I'm talking about the biological parent and the step parent. It's important for
everyone to be on the same page.
On the same page and have a good relationship. Mm-hmm. And just understand that we're working towards the same goal, and that's to, you know, do the best thing for the children.
Right. And it may take some more than one conversation to reach an agreement and come up with common rules. For example, how late do they stay up when they're visiting?
And that's a good point. Just be patient with yourself, because it does take time blend and to...
But once you do establish those rules, then the child knows, and the rules should be the same regardless of which household they're in at the time.
And that's why it's important to have a really good relationship with the biological parents.
Mm-hmm.
And just let them, help them understand that you love their children like your own.
Yes.
And that you want the best for the children. So, but never, ever ask your child to be a spy or tattle about what is going on in the other person's home. Ask the child if they have any concerns or complaints about the visit. And that's okay, because you do want to know that your mm-hmm. children are being cared for and not mistreated. Mm-hmm.
And if they have any concerns, they should feel it's okay to share that with you.
Mm-hmm.
You want to stay in touch with them about that. Mm-hmm.
And be sure to update financial papers for the family, such as wills and insurance policies. And that is something Mel and I had to do. And it's a sensitive area. It really is.
That's right.
But it's important to get it done.
And I remember for us, it's something I had on my to-do list. Mm-hmm. We talked about it. We knew it needed to be done, updating wills, accounts, et cetera. But it took me over a year to really get all that done. And so, but that type of change needs to be made. Changes need to be made with the financial papers.
And you just have to be patient with each other. Mm-hmm. It takes time, especially if a spouse has passed on.
Right.
Be very patient about that.
Okay, look for an experienced Christian blended couple in your church to help or mentor you. There are so many around now, and you may notice them, but now that you're kind of joined the club, it's good to find a couple that can work with you, that are willing to mentor you. In fact, if you approach them and compliment them, you notice that they've gone through this, or listen as they explain that, then you can ask them to help you or mentor you. And normally people will be helpful. Your situation may be unique, may be a little different. As we mentioned, there are different types of blended families, but it's good to find a couple that has already walked down that road and can assist you.
And it's just a good idea to have an accountability partner anyway.
Yes. That you can talk
to. Mm-hmm. And just bounce things off
mm-hmm.
if there's some issues coming up. So it's very important to pray together and ask God for wisdom and direction to parent your children.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's there to help. And that's something that it's a good habit to do.
Yes.
Realize in God's eyes, a blended family is never second class. He loves all families the same.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, most well-known Old Testament families were blended. Moses changed his family. The prophet Samuel changed his family. I mean, if you really go and look at it, there are many examples, Old Testament, of families that were blended. In fact, we became blended family members when we were adopted into the family of God, as Gentiles, for example.
And as a couple, read Christian books about the blended family to learn how to prepare and manage the transition. And that is something that I actually did before Mel and I got married.
Mm-hmm.
We had attended a number of marriage
conferences
mm-hmm. and if that's not something that you have done, we recommend it highly mm-hmm. because it's always good to get away.
Yeah.
But you get to meet other people who are going through the same experience that you're going through.
And many of these conferences now have sessions on blended families because the numbers are there, the need is there.
And you get materials to help you once you go home to refer back to. So that's very important.
Yes. Step Family Resources. Books by Ron Deal include The Smart Step Family. He also has videos, The Smart Step Family Marriage, The Smart Step Dad, The Smart Step Mom, and the Family Life Blended website is where you can find Christian resources to help strengthen step families, prevent re-divorce, and help break the generational cycle of divorce.
And also on this website, you will find a podcast on blended family topics, and you'll find free downloadable resources as well. They're all very good. I recommend them highly. You'll find a link to Family Life Ministry, which has a variety of Christian resources you can listen to, read, watch, and even sign up to attend blended family events.
So by following these tips and using these resources, one of the things that we know is that your family can not only successfully blend, but they can be blended and blessed. As we started off this series of the last show, looking at this picture, I mean, it looks like, you know, a happy family here. They have blended. But I tell you, to reach this level, what does it take? It takes a lot of
patience.
A lot of patience.
Love.
It takes a lot of love.
And confidence.
Yes. And yes.
I can be very sensitive at times regarding some things.
It's a sensitive topic. It is sensitive. Trying to blend folks together. Yeah.
And I had a certain expectation because in my first marriage, as I mentioned earlier, I got along really well with the my first husband's children. As a matter of fact, we're still the oldest daughter. We're still very close. And
yes. And so the expectation was that this would be as easy as the first one, but people are different and it was a little different
situation.
Yes. So as you can see, there are indeed tips that you can follow to successfully blend the family, and there are resources out there. If you need help, get help. If there's a situation where the problem seems to be bigger than the parents and the child can handle, seek counseling. But I will tell you, it will take time, patience, and a lot of love. In addition, you can ask God for wisdom, how to be a better parent.
It will keep you on your knees, that's for sure.
But, that's right. If you think you can't stand it, kneel. And by doing this, your family can be blended and blessed.
And if there's one piece of advice I would give, I mentioned earlier that I had this certain expectation that because I had a really great relationship with my first husband's children and we all got along well, I mean, there was a little transition, but so be patient with yourself and the family that you're blending with.
That's right. It takes time, not just with the children, but with yourself.
And excellent point. A lot of love.
All right.
Yes.
So as we conclude, for questions or comments, feel free to contact us at livingagodlymarriage@gmail.com. And one thing we always want you to remember,
that living a godly marriage
is the best marriage.
Thank you for joining us.
God bless you. Bye-bye.